Ravi, stick with me for just a moment. You referenced Mount Everest. I have a report from a man who was there at the time of the earthquake. Roll that tape.
Hello, guys. This is Arjun from Advanced Base Camp of Makalu. We've had a lot of disturbance here due to the earthquake, which was reported in Nepal. All along that base, now it's covered into clouds. We had quite a big few big avalanches coming down of those phases. From here, we had quite a bit of rockfall. Most of our team is okay. We're doing well. Some of our team members just moved up today towards Camp 1 and Camp 2. We still do not have any report from them. We're trying to get in touch with them. Some people have gone up towards Camp 1. We should hear from them soon. I hope all is well up there. See you.
Ravi, the earthquake struck at about midday local time. Not that there's ever a good time for an earthquake to strike, but what type of customs, what type of local activities were people engaged with midday on a Saturday?
Well, you know, as with any other city, I mean, to speak of Kathmandu, first of all, you know, tourism is a major part of industry in Nepal and, of course, in Kathmandu. So, you know, on a typical Saturday, you would imagine many tourists in town. You would imagine the schools may be closed. You would imagine that, you know, people may be going about their Saturdays, sitting at cafes, sitting at restaurants. Some of them may be working. The earthquake struck around about 11:40 a.m., so, you know, obviously good daylight at least. But, you know, many hours on, you know, what they're going to face now and you know, with rain, the struggle they're going to face is trying to rescue people who may be trapped. So as you say, that there is no good time, but, you know, the fact that it took place at midday, you know, means that we have video, we have images, we've heard from people there, you know, so, you know, the people of Nepal right now need any advantage they can get, I guess.